When you crave fruit, are you more likely to reach for an apple? Or do you love a nice glass of orange juice or a few orange slices? When it comes to food or fruit choices, it really depends on your taste buds and personal preference. For diabetics, the choice is even more important, since certain foods can drastically spike blood sugar levels, and with limited food choices, you want to ensure that you're getting all the nutrients your body needs. For instance, did you know that research links one of these fruits to a reduced risk of diabetes? Or that one has almost double the calories of the other? So what's the deal with apples and oranges and diabetes? These facts might shock you. In this video, we'll explore apples versus oranges and determine which is actually better for blood sugar control. But first, please like this video and subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to ring that bell for notifications so you can be one of the first to get all the latest videos from us. And stick around, we'll be giving away 2 free gifts and you won't want to miss them. Now, let's dive straight into everything you need to know about oranges. It's safe to say that oranges are one of the most popular fruits around. This is the cool kid on the block. As part of the citrus fruit family, this fruit has a mysterious past. What we do know is that oranges were cultivated in Eastern Asia thousands upon thousands of years ago. And today, you can find oranges in most warm regions, like Florida. While most love to consume this fresh fruit, it is also widely enjoyed as a juice. Who doesn't love a good old glass of orange juice with breakfast in the morning? Now, oranges are very nutritious. 100 grams of oranges has only 47 calories, 0.9 grams of protein, 11.8 grams of carbs, 0.1 grams of fat, 100% of your recommended daily intake of vitamin C, vitamin B1, vitamin B9, and potassium. Here's another surprise. Oranges are actually 87% water. They keep you hydrated, making them a great go-to on a hot summer day. But what are the health benefits? We've got 5. First, oranges can help improve and maintain your eye health. Various evidence shows that vitamin C helps lower the risk of cataracts, slow the progression of age-related macular degeneration, and slows vision loss. How does it do this? Vitamin C contributes to the development of collagen, which provides structure to the eyes. Vitamin C also acts as an antioxidant in the body, which can prevent your cells from harm, and this includes protecting your eyes. Second, oranges can help improve your heart health. Heart disease is one of the leading causes of death worldwide. A particular plant compound known as flavonoid, which is found in oranges, may have protective effects when it comes to your heart and cardiovascular system. Research also shows how oranges and orange juice have blood-thinning effects, meaning it can help reduce your blood pressure. The fiber found in oranges may also contribute to decreased cholesterol levels. All of these things means improved heart and cardiovascular function. And this is inevitably so important for your overall health. With a healthy cardiovascular system, your organs and tissues can easily get the nutrients and compounds they need to do what they do best. Third, oranges may help with weight loss. A single orange contains 12% of your daily fiber intake. A diet high in fiber has so many wonderful benefits. It can help with blood sugar control, more on this in a bit. It can also help promote regular bowel movements, lower cholesterol levels, and maintain a healthy weight or help lose weight. So how does this work exactly? It's actually super simple. Fiber keeps you fuller longer by slowing digestion. This means that you are less likely to get hungry right after a high fiber meal. And oranges can be a part of that. Fourth, oranges may help prevent anemia. Anemia happens when the body doesn't have enough red blood cells to be able to carry enough oxygen to the areas that need it. This is most common when there is an iron deficiency present. And no, oranges are not a source of iron, but get this, vitamin C and citric acid, both found in oranges, can help your body better absorb iron. And this means you're less likely to be iron deficient. In turn, anemia is less likely to occur. And last but not least, oranges may prevent kidney stones. Kidney stones aren't anyone's idea of a fun time, but interestingly, eating oranges might help prevent kidney stones altogether. Oranges contain citrates and citric acid. Citrates and citric acid bind to calcium, which prevents stones from forming. In fact, potassium citrate is frequently prescribed to kidney stone patients, and now you know why. So if you're prone to kidney stones, oranges might be one fruit you want to start including in your regular diet. So what about diabetics? Can oranges help with blood sugar control? Oranges are rated 43 on the glycemic index scale. Meanwhile, orange juice is rated 50. This means they impact your blood sugar, but don't impact it too much. And this can actually help keep your blood sugar levels stable, especially if you have diabetes. The fiber in oranges is particularly relevant here, since it can slow digestion, ensuring your blood sugar levels don't spike too high. In conclusion, oranges are great options for diabetics, yet they are high in carbs, so it's important to avoid eating too much and making sure you're including plenty of protein and fat alongside any oranges you eat. Now, let's pick apart apples. But before we do, let's get you those two free gifts. Our free book, 10 Incredible Foods That Reduce Blood Sugar, will teach you all about what kinds of foods you should eat to manage your diabetes. In The Scary Truth About Sugar, you'll learn everything about how sugar affects your body and your health. Click the link in the description below to grab these two incredible gifts. Now, back to apples. Apples are easy to grab on the go. A quick wash and you can grab a bite of this tasty fruit. The average medium-sized apple includes 95 calories, 25 grams of carbs, 14% of your daily vitamin C intake, 6% of your daily potassium intake, and 5% of your daily vitamin K intake. They also contain 2-4% of your daily needs for copper, manganese, vitamin A, vitamin E, vitamin B1, vitamin B2, and vitamin B6. So, what are all the health benefits of apples? First, apples may help improve heart health. Apples contain soluble fiber, which helps with lowering cholesterol blood levels. But make sure you eat that peel. The apple peel actually contains half of the total amount of fiber in apples. On top of this, the apple peel also contains polyphenols. Polyphenols have antioxidant effects. This means they protect your body from damage caused by free radicals. Studies have also linked these polyphenols to a 20% reduced risk of having a stroke. Other research has further compared apples to having the same effectiveness of statins when it comes to reducing death caused by heart disease. That's pretty powerful stuff. Hey, maybe an apple a day can really keep the doctor away. Number two, apples promote good gut health. Apples are jam-packed with pectin. Pectin is a fiber that acts as a prebiotic in the gut. What does this mean? Pectin actually feeds the good bacteria in your digestive tract, and this can encourage proper digestion of the food you eat. In fact, some researchers go as far as to say that pectin might be the reason apples are considered so effective against obesity, diabetes, and heart disease. And with that, number three is apples may contribute to healthy weight loss. Apples, similar to oranges, are full of water and fiber. These two entities make them the perfect snack if your goal is weight loss. Both water and fiber are filling, keeping you fuller longer, and preventing unnecessary snacking between meals. In fact, one study shows individuals who began their meals with apple slices actually ate 200 fewer calories than those who didn't. Apples are also lower in calories, especially when compared to popular pre-packaged and processed food items. If your goal is to lose weight or achieve a healthy weight, include more apples in your diet. They just might help. Number 4. Apples might improve your cognition and slow mental decline. Animal studies, specifically, have shown how apple juice decreased harmful substances in the brain, which minimized cognitive decline. Through similar animal research, experts also theorize that apples might preserve an essential neurotransmitter in the brain called acetylcholine. A decline in this neurotransmitter is linked to Alzheimer's disease. Thus, eating more apples might help prevent the development of this neurodisorder. Number 5. Apples might help fight and prevent asthma. Apples are rich in antioxidants. Experts assume that because of this, apples can help prevent oxidative stress in the lungs, which may lead to asthma. Large studies have even shown this to be true. In one study, eating 15% of a large apple was associated with a 10% reduced risk of asthma. It's thought that this is achieved by flavonoids found in apples. These flavonoids reduce inflammation and regulate the immune system, all which can help reduce the risk of asthma. So again, what about diabetics? Apples are actually an excellent choice for those with diabetes. In fact, a ton of research links the consumption of apples to a reduced risk of diabetes. One study even linked apples to a 28% lower risk. It's thought apples might help do this by supporting the beta cells of the pancreas, which are responsible for reducing insulin. People with type 2 diabetes often have damaged beta cells. This means they don't produce the proper amount of insulin to help manage glucose in the blood. Apples, further, are rated low on the glycemic index scale at 39. This means they won't drastically spike your blood sugar levels. Thus, more apples in your diet might help. So, what's the verdict on apples versus oranges? Well, both. Apples and oranges are wonderful and healthy choices for diabetics. But if you had the choice, apples might be better. They are lower on the glycemic index scale, and research indicates that they can protect beta cells in the pancreas, which is key for combating and managing diabetes. At the same time, oranges aren't bad. They also contain a ton of nutrients, and they too can be part of a healthy and balanced diabetic diet. Most importantly, discuss your diet with your doctor. This is especially important if you have been diagnosed with diabetes. They can help you determine how to properly manage this condition and even potentially reverse it. After all, your diet is truly the foundation of your overall health. Additionally, certain foods work well for some people, yet not so great for others. Your doctor knows you and your health situation the best and can help you determine a diet that allows you to live your best life. So, there you have it. Apples might be a bit better than oranges for blood sugar control, yet this doesn't mean you shouldn't also enjoy oranges as a diabetic. We hope this video was helpful, and we want to hear what you think. Let us know if we missed anything, or if you have anything to add, in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, hit that like button, and ring that bell for notifications. Before you leave this video, grab your 2 free gifts by clicking the links in the description below. You'll get our free book, 10 Incredible Foods That Reduce Blood Sugar, and our 1-hour documentary, The Scary Truth About Sugar. There's so much great info in both of those that you don't want to miss. Thanks for watching. We hope you're having a diabetes-fighting day.